Group 4, and we are going to talk about Lecture 5, which is adhesive system and bonding. We all know that almost all adhesives used today are organic polymer. Organic materials are chemical compounds containing carbon and hydrogen as their component. Polymer are macromolecules, which are long chains made up of the combination of many repeating units. This polymer is derived from the polymerizing of smaller molecules, which are called the monomer. For example, polyethylene is derived from the monomer, which is ethylene. Polymerization is a chemical reaction in which the molecules of monomer are linked together to form a large molecule whose molecular weight is a multiple of that of the original substance. Polymers are divided into two types. The first one is homopolymer. It is a polymer which is derived from the polymerization of a single monomer. For example, polyethylene and polyvinyl chloride. The next is copolymer. Copolymer is a polymer which is derived from the polymerization of more than one polymer. For example, phenylformaldehyde and urea-formaldehyde. And copolymer can be divided to three arrangements. The first one is randomly arranged, and second is alternately arranged, and the third is grafted. Grafted is with a backbone. So the type of polymerization is very much controlled by the nature and physical properties of the monomer. So I would like to explain some terms that will be heard in the following video. And the first one is molecular weight. It is the measure of the weight of all the elements in a molecule. The next is degree of polymerization, dp. It is the repeating units of a polymer. So I would like to pass to another member to proceed to other parts of this video.
With resin polymer. So for the resin polymer, we can actually classify them into two, which is thermoplastic and also thermosetting. So they actually, both of them have the terms thermo, which actually we can know that they are related to the heat. So let's proceed to thermoplastic with more details. So for the thermoplastic resins, the term thermoplastic are means to be denoting substance, especially synthetic resins, that become softer on heating and harder on cooling. They are also able to repeat these processes continuously. The example would include polyethylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride, and also polypropylene. So actually the main characteristic of thermoplastics are they are linear polymer molecules which we are able to soften and flow on heating and solidify on cooling. Next, in the application aspects of thermoplastic resins, the application of thermoplastic resins will actually require heat and also extrusion. So the characteristic will be fusible, which are able to fuse or melt easily, soluble, soften when heated, and creep under stress. The advantages of using thermoplastic resins are fast curing and also simple to use. So the application of thermoplastic resins including book binder, packaging boxes, and also plastic films in the laminate. Next, I will proceed to thermosetting resins. So thermosetting resins is actually a petrochemical material that in reversibly cures, and the cure may be brought by the action of heat, catalyst, ultraviolet light, and also ultrasound. So it's actually leading them into an infusible stage, which are not able to be melted or fused. So the main characteristic of the mosaics is that they require curing. So when they actually undergoes a molecular cross-linking processes, which is irreversible and renders them infusible. That actually will therefore offer a high thermal stability, good rigidity and hardness, and also resistant to creep. So overall, thermoplastic resins and thermosetting resins, they have the differences. So the thermoplastic resins can melts when heated and hardens when cold, while thermosetting resins are hardens when heated but no longer melts after it hardens once.
So for adhesive bond formation, we have two types, which is the first one is addition polymerization and the second one is the condensation polymerization. For addition polymerization is a change lightening using radical and ionic or cationic catalyst. It have two states, which is the polymer has two reactive side or polymer with more than two reactive sites. If polymer have the two reactive sites, it can grow only one reaction to a strain, such as ethylene or strain or phenyl chloride. And the second one, if polymer have more than two reactive sites, it can grow to more than one reaction to a strain, such as the phenol and formaldehyde. It can become a phenol formaldehyde polymer, and it can have thousands or hundreds of thousand number of hands. And the second one is condensation polymerization, is a change lengthening involve the reaction of monomers and the elimination of a byproduct such as water. So this reaction can be arrest or stopped by cooling and reinstant to continue chain growth. So we have four setting of curing of water adhesive. The first one is solvent loss. Solvent loss is evaporation or diffusion into substrate such as water or organic liquid, right? So it is the same concept as the 3-second glue that we found in the convenience store supermarkets, that we use polyvinyl acetate PVA in the household applicants. And the second one is melting and cooling. Melting of course include heat and pressure to melt the substrate, right? It's same concept like a glue gun, hot glue gun, that can be used for book bindings, package sealing, or the plastic labels. And we use it is used adhesive that a combination of PVA and polyester. And the third one is chemical reaction. It is a chemical reaction between the number of functional group or result of insoluble and infusible of film that can withstand extreme weather. So it can be used at outdoor applicants. And the type of disease is rosocinol formaldehyde or phenolrosocinol formaldehyde. And last but not least is a pressure sensitive action. It is have a high degree of tackiness and stickiness because of a high solid content. And because the high solid content, it only can be used normally for the lower structural strength of applicants, right?
So hello, I will talk about the adhesive composition. There are 10 adhesive composition, which is firstly is a base, a solid substance that will provide the backbone of the adhesive system. And secondly is a solvent, which is liquid media that will require to dissolve or disperse the base material and provide liquefied system of all the components. Next is catalyst, which is to increase the reaction rate during curing or the hardening process. And also next is curing agent, which is added to the resin, which can help to increase the extent of resin curing. As standards, they have similar function as filler, but is usually used in a larger proportion. And filler itself is to increase viscosity of adhesive system, and also modify the mechanical properties and thermal expansion coefficient of the film. And next is diluents, or known as thinner, used together with solvent to produce low viscosity system, suitable for spraying and other special usage. And also preservatives that basically used as a protection against biological deterioration. And fortifiers aim at increasing the strength of the base resin. So last but not least is a carriers, used in producing film type adhesive, and consists of very thin fabric on paper or paper on which adhesive are applied on.
Properties of adhesive. There are 5 properties of adhesive, which is viscosity, solid content, pH, specific gravity, and gel time. For the viscosity, it controls the spreading and penetration of adhesive, can be manipulated to suit moisture content of wood and assembly time. Resin usually has viscosity of less than 700 cp, and adhesive usually has viscosity of more than 2000 cp. And then for the solid content, the amount of solid through resin in the adhesive or resin. And for the pH, it controls the curing rate of resin. For the specific gravity, it measures the amount of actual resin solid in relation to water. And for the last is gel time. Gel time is time taken for the adhesive to gel, not harden or cure. there are five factors in selecting an adhesive, which is material to be bonded, which is chemical composition, wettability, solvent and heat resistance of the adherent, porosity and permeability of adherent. Second, stress which will be put on the bonded panels, mechanical load type, levels, duration, and then for personal safety. And third is bond exposure and durability required, whether resistance needed. And for the fourth is fulfilling the conditions required for bonding. And for the last is economic consideration, for example, cost of basic adhesive.